Hey guys. All right. Welcome to my Friday night virtual dinner date. This crazy idea I came up with a little while ago when COVID started, this pandemic, and it was my way of connecting with people. Hey Maureen. Oh, here's my people. Cindy, hi! All right, I hope you can hear my music. My music is completely women and motivating and powerful for women because of our election. Also, the theme this week is red, white, and blue because of our election. And I'm doing berries and blueberries and strawberries. And I decided to do a cake because it's my middle son's birthday. So happy birthday, my love. He gave me a granddaughter this year, which, oh my gosh, made me so happy. I love the way babies smell. I get to see her and smell her, and I love their curiosity. I forgot everything. The sound of a bird is incredible to them. So we're doing a dessert tonight, which I made in advance. Sue Seeger, hi honey. Miss you guys. What are you girls reading these days? So many good books. Did you read the Where the Crawdads Sing? Love that one. And I found a new group of fantastic women out here in California, so that was one of the first things I did, is I found a book group, because I love to read. Alright, cheers everybody, happy birthday to my son. I keep saying I'm going to do this for as long as COVID is going on, so who knows how long it's going to go on. I would love to know, I'd love feedback. So do me a favor, not just tonight, during this, the garden cook. Oh, Australia, I've got friends in Florence and Italy and Barcelona, Cassie, my sister, and New Jersey and Florida. Love you guys. All right, let's do, I did an olive oil cake, which, I'm gonna take a sip. Hear my soundtrack? This is in Heart to Table. And I titled it, I noticed, and it's really interesting, I don't bake much anymore. I don't even have the equipment to bake anymore. I had to go out and get a whole bunch of stuff that I just don't have anymore. Don't need it, nobody needs it. But sometimes having a cake around is a nice thing, right? I titled it Lemon Olive Oil Cake, but I found an orange in my refrigerator, so I actually made this with orange, which is just incredible. You guys, powdered sugar, and by the way, this recipe that's in there, and I only flaunt my cake, my recipe because all the proceeds go to a food pantry here in Venice, California. And we're doing amazing, wonderful work. I literally started to deliver the food to people's homes a couple of weeks ago. And so that's pretty cool, because they can't come anymore, but they need the food and our numbers are up. So please go on Amazon and buy it. You're doing a good thing. And it's filled with lots of great recipes. You know what's really interesting is because it's my son's birthday, this was my original book, and this also has some really great family recipes. I did it because I was going through a transition in my life, and it's all the things that I thought I wanted them to know, the recipes that we grew up with. And they all turned out to be great cooks, and their spouses are great cooks. It's really fun when they call every once in a while and ask for a recipe and advice. The best recipes. Thank you, Helly. Put that in the comments. So I'd love comments. I'd love to know where people are that are watching this, put a heart, because then I don't know who's watching it. Let me know what recipes you want me to do. You want me to do more desserts, more healthy things. I don't cook with much meat anymore, but let me know. Anyway, so here we go. Olive oil cake. Powdered sugar on top. And I bought one of these. Check this out. Ooh, look how pretty. And so you want to put a little bit of powdered sugar on top to make it purty. What I love about this, there's so many things I love about this recipe, is you can make it for entertaining. You can make it a day, even 2 days before. It gets even better. Because it has olive oil in it, it gets even better. And it does it, I love icing, love icing, but it's not super sugary because it doesn't have icing on top. Matter of fact, because I don't have much sugar in my diet anymore, When I was making it, the recipe calls for a cup and a half of sugar. I only did a cup. That's enough. So if you get the book, just like revise it. It doesn't need a whole cup and a half, I don't think. Let's see. Ooh, do you hear the soundtrack? Ooh, the girl that does my hair, she said, "Megan, please bring me a piece tomorrow." Ooh, Britney Spears. I had to put, I don't think my sons watch the show that I do, but I had to put Britney Spears in honor of him, because with his birthday, and I love a theme, he was crazy about Britney Spears, and I did a surprise Britney Spears birthday party for 1 year. And this is a cool song! All right, so I made blueberry compote for us. If you follow me, I did that a couple of weeks ago. I don't know, I'm not professional, but drizzle a little bit of blueberry compote. And then I made us, because you're supposed to pretend you're here. That's the idea. You're here and I'm cooking for you. It's virtual. I made us raspberry syrup. So do some raspberry sauce on top. And then, so what you do when you entertain, and that's the whole idea of this, I love to entertain and I miss entertaining. Oh, I miss entertaining. And my girlfriends are all like, "When can we come over?" I'm like, not yet. Hey, Tess. And you know what? I want my Boston friends here too. New Jersey people. I'm gonna have a huge party. When this is over, I'm gonna throw the hugest party. Everyone's gonna have to fly in. I'm gonna rent, I don't know, a huge space. And then add some berries, red, white, and blue berries, because, and that's why the theme of this week, I am so delighted, especially now being a mother, a grandmother to a girl. And look, you guys, let's all, I say PPP, let's be patient, let's be peaceful, and let's be positive. With our election, and I know some of my friends from foreign countries are watching this, let's all be peaceful, patient, and positive. It's gonna all turn out okay. It's gonna turn out the way it was supposed to, and having a granddaughter now, having a female vice president is huge for me. I just find it so exciting. Anyway, so here we are. Food for thought. I have to try it. I don't do much. It probably, tomorrow will be even better. It's one of these recipes where, and I like, and by the way, when you go to Italy, they're not huge on sugary desserts, right? Because their food is fantastic, right? Oh my God. And so when dessert comes, sometimes they just put out a bowl of oranges or nectarines and walnuts. Like they're not big on dessert. So it's one of these lovely desserts It's, and I'm so glad I didn't do a cup and a half. I didn't need it. Yeah, so food for thought. I like to end with food for thought. And my food for thought, work it out. I love Britney Spears. So it's Beyonce and I Am Woman, Hear Me Roar. Do you hear it? Food for thought this week. My father used to say to me, when I had an amazing relationship with my father, big Italian guy who I worship, he used to say, babe, dreams are for free, so you might as well dream big. And I love that. And I like to relate this to COVID. And my mother was this little, tiny little Irish woman, blonde hair and strawberry blonde hair, like almost like my granddaughter, which is kind of crazy, blue eyes, really pretty girl. So he was a dreamer and she was, you know, fighting Irish. You know, whenever they show the Irish, they always show fists. And she was a hard worker. I think that combination is what makes dreams come true, right? So you dream and then you figure out what steps you have to do to make your dreams come true, which is a really nice combination, especially as a daughter growing up. It was wonderful. They were wonderful parents. Not such good lovers, but great parents. I love the idea of like just dreaming of what we want to have happen in our lives, and certainly now. I know for me, when this is all over, the fact is, this actually becomes very simple. I think what we're gonna learn is what's really important in life, right? I wanna see my kids on the East Coast. I wanna see my friends in foreign countries. I don't know. What do you want to do? I would love to hear people's comments. Send me comments and tell me what it is you want when COVID is over. Let's dream. Let's dream about what we want to happen when it's over. Cheers. Happy birthday. Hi, Maureen. Looks beautiful. It really is. It's you know, it's the berries. It's, and when I tell you, it's wonderful for entertaining because tomorrow it's gonna be even more moist. This is my dinner, by the way. This is vodka. Yeah, I'm healthy all day and at night, who the hell knows what's gonna happen. I wanna go to Montana. All right, oh, take me with you. I wanna go to Montana too. I've never been. Bye, you guys, I love you. Send me comments, hit the heart, so I know who's watching. Tell me if I should continue this. I don't know, should I stop? Love you guys, bye. Have a great weekend, more important than bye.